This week, marijuana businesses seek better banking options, body cameras hit the streets with DPD, and we're showing you how to take care of your pets in the cold weather. It's all happening in your city now. I'm Paula Vargas. This is YCN.
A recent federal ruling stifled Colorado's attempt to bring the marijuana business into the banking system.
Colorado set up the framework for us to have a marijuana credit union, and that business started going forward.
But before opening its doors, Fourth Corner Credit Union needed a master account. Federal law prohibits the sale of marijuana, so the Federal Reserve's Kansas City Bank rejected the bank's application. Fourth Corner Credit filed a suit to force the Reserve's hand, but the U.S. District Judge R. Brooke Jackson dismissed the suit last week, calling for a congressional solution to the inconsistencies of state and federal views of marijuana legality, leaving Denver with few banking solutions for cash-heavy cannabis businesses.
One of the things that we're concerned about with the lack of access to banking is the fact that in Denver, our marijuana businesses are the second most frequently burglarized type of business here in Denver.
While Denver implements short-term measures like increased security for delivery of cash tax payments, the only real fix for this problem has to happen at the national level.
But we'll just have to wait and see.
A longstanding gun policy changes at the Denver Museum of Nature and Science.
Very disappointing to find out through the news that the Denver Museum of Natural History is going to allow weapons on site. Concealed or otherwise, I think it's inappropriate.
The new policy asks permit holders to make contact with the museum's security should they feel the need to bring a gun while visiting.
The first wave of body cameras for Denver police officers hit the streets last week.
Currently, the first 200 cameras are being implemented in District 6, the gang unit and traffic operations.
At a news conference, commanders said they will continue to welcome public input on the project as everyone is still in a learning curve.
The officers will still activate them in the same situations as far as during traffic stops, during pedestrian, citizen, or vehicle contacts, during crisis intervention team calls, weapons calls, calls involving suicidal individuals, during foot chases, during any adversarial encounter that the officer encounters, forced entries, warrantless or consensual searches during Miranda advisements, arrests and citations, or any time an officer believes that the body-worn camera may be beneficial to document either a crime that has occurred or to provide better clarity as to how an incident had occurred.
So we're confident that the body-worn cameras are going to strengthen the public's trust and demonstrate the professionalism of our officers.
Don't let the cold weather affect your four-legged friends. Denver Animal Protection has advice on what to do to keep your furry family safe.
The cold weather affects what we do. We receive way more calls during the winter about dogs being outside in the cold, and we have to go make sure that they have the appropriate shelter so that they're safe during the wintertime. There's ways to keep them warm, especially if they're short-haired or small. You can do the jackets. All the local pet stores around have jackets you can put on your dogs. You can do the booties. And those keep their paws a little warmer, and it keeps their paws out of the chemicals that people put down to de-ice everything around them. And you just got to make sure you're watching your pet for signs of being too cold. So if they're lifting up their paws, if they're refusing to walk anymore, if they're shivering, those are all signs it's time to come back inside.
The shelter also offers weekend clinics where you can get your pet vaccinated and microchipped in case your cat wanders off seeking warmth on a cold night.
A team known for bringing their A game to the playoffs is coming to Sports Authority Field. Choosing a place to catch our boys taking on the Steelers is almost as important as the quarterback we put in. Retro Room on Larimer scores big with $3 You Call It and plenty of flavor-infused vodkas. We can't say what LC's stands for on television, but its neighbors on Tennyson say it means good times and authentic Mexican food. Or make a day of our first playoff game. Have brunch at Governor's Park Tavern in Capitol Hill from 10 to 2 and stay for the sirens every time the Broncos score a TD.
Celebrate the largest Martin Luther King Jr. march and rally in the United States. Participants gather at City Park and march to Civic Center Park, where a large rally commemorates the life of Martin Luther King Jr.
Tune in every Friday evening for a new edition of YCN. Thanks for watching.